guys, it's me Kylie, or Kybro, and just letting you guys know, this video is not meant to offend anyone, it's not meant to be disrespectful or rude. I simply find this stuff fascinating, and I hope you do as well. I mean, no disrespect to any family or anyone who was involved, and I'm simply just trying to get the information out there about the victims and spread awareness. So, enjoy! It was on December 20th of 1968 that 17-year-old David Faraday and 17-year-old Betty Lou Jensen parked here on Lover's Lane for their first date. They promised to be home by 11 o'clock, but sadly, they could not keep their promise because while here, they were shot to death by who would be known as the Zodiac Killer, a famous killer in the 1960s who has yet to be caught. And if he was around the age of 20, by now, if he's still alive, he should be around 71 years old. So this place clearly has no trespassing. It's barred off. Previously, someone had spray painted the Zodiac Killer sign on that board, which had the circle with the crossroads through it. Here in Blue Rock Springs Park on July 4th of 1969, Darlene Burren and Mike McGee were fatally shot by a 9mm here in the parking lot by a mysterious man who just came up to the passenger side window. Now, these two friends were simply just having a chat in the car when they noticed a mysterious car pull in and back out of the parking lot. So, once Darlene was shot first and she sadly died from the incident, Mike was also shot, however he did not die, so he was able to give a description to the police, hence the drawing that I will insert here that we currently have today. Now, only minutes after the shooting, the police received a phone call from a man claiming that he was the killer. He also claimed that he killed the kids in the on Lover's Lane the previous summer and said details that only the police and the killer could know. This is when letters started arriving to the police station with ciphers saying that if they decoded the message, they would know the killer's identity. Stop at the third site where the Zodiac Killer struck, two college students having a nice day by the lake on September 27th of 1969, which is the same year as the last killings. It was on these very shores back in 1969 when the Zodiac Killer struck again. However, this time he struck two college students named Cecilia Shepherd and Brian Hartnell. Now, these two students were just relaxing on the lake, laying in the grass, when Cecilia noticed a suspicious man lurking in the trees. All of a sudden, this bizarre man came up dressed in a sweater with a stitched white cross circle in the middle. He tied them both up with clothesline and held them at gunpoint, telling them that he was going to rob them. However, he did much more than that. This man decided to stab them both with a foot-long knife before leaving them both for dead. He called the police, explaining that he'd killed them both, explaining the exact location, model of the car, and he even carved in their car door, September 27th of 69, killed with a knife. Luckily, Brian Hartnell survived this, but sadly, Cecilia did not. This was only one of many of the other Zodiac killings that are unexplained and still remain open cases till today. Hey you guys, so we finally got to San Francisco, which is the last confirmed location of the Zodiac Killer's killing. Now, the last victim that we are going to talk about and see where it happened is Paul Stein, who was a taxi cab driver in 1969. On October 11th of 1969, taxi cab driver Paul Stein came to his last and final drop-off. Now, a mysterious man reportedly from the Weston Francis Hotel, gone to his cab and asked to be dropped off on the corner of Beery and Mason. However, this man had murder on his mind and ended up being the Zodiac Killer. Once the cab was pulled over, the Zodiac Killer murdered Paul, and it was the last and final confirmed location and kill of the Zodiac Killer. Even though in 1974, the Zodiac Killer wrote another letter called the Exorcist Letter, claiming that he had killed over 37 people. Hey you guys, congrats, you made it to the end of the video, and I hope you enjoyed it. And if you want other haunted tours or perhaps other murders, comment below different video ideas and I'll make sure to get to them as soon as possible. So have a fantastic day.